From Kashmir to Kanyakumari, India is a spellbinding mosaic of cultures, traditions, languages, and an extraordinary mingling civilization. Keeping its age-old culture maintained, today the country is taking huge strides on the path of development. Namaskar viewers, welcome back to another episode of My India. I'm your host Prateeksha Mishra, and in today's episode, we're going to offer you a glimpse into India's cultures, diversity, along with the developments happening in and around the world. People across India celebrated the auspicious Ram Navami festival to commemorate the birth of Lord Ram. The festival was indeed widely celebrated with more zeal and devotion after the consecration ceremony of Ram Temple in Ayodhya. The festival holds significant cultural and religious importance in India, uniting people from various communities in the celebration of their shared heritage and spiritual beliefs. Take a look.
सजा दो घर को दुल्हन सा हाँ घर राम आए
है महोत्सव का आज राम नामी है
In India, religious beliefs are like a colorful tapestry made up of many diverse ideas and rituals that have grown over thousands of years. The nation was once again ablaze with excitement and devotion as it marked Ram Navami, the birth anniversary of Lord Ram. The ceremony this year was especially significant after the Pran Pratishtha of the magnificent Ram Temple in Ayodhya. Thousands of Hindu devotees thronged the holy city to celebrate the occasion of Ram Navami for the first time after the opening of the grand temple dedicated to Lord Ram. They offered prayers and also took a holy dip in the nearby Saryu River while chanting religious hymns. A unique ritual illuminating the forehead of Lord Ram's idol naturally with sunlight attracted thousands of Hindu devotees on the occasion to the temple to experience the spectacle. Believed to be the birthplace of Lord Ram, Ayodhya holds immense spiritual significance for devout Hindus.
बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है, ऐसा लग रहा है राम तब नहीं आज जन्म ले रहे हैं। ऐसा उत्साह, ऐसा उल्लास, घर-घर में राम जन्म ले रहे हैं।
Ram Navami is one of the most celebrated festivals by the Hindu community. There's a strong feeling of devotion and faith in the air during the festival as devotees throng temple grounds, offer prayers and seek Lord Ram's blessings. The celebration of Ram Navami transcends religious boundaries and brings people from diverse backgrounds together in a spirit of unity and devotion. People gathered in temples and homes to offer prayers and perform rituals seeking blessings and divine grace.
जी आज का विशेष महत्व है राम के जन्म के उपलक्ष में जो है यहाँ के स्नान से पुण्य प्राप्त होता है इसलिए जो है हम लोग काशी नगरी से अयोध्या नगरी में आए हैं
राम नवमी ऑफन कोइंसाइड्स विद द नाइन्थ डे ऑफ चैत्र नवरात्रि अ नाइन डे फेस्टिवल डेडिकेटेड टू द वर्शिप ऑफ द गॉडेस दुर्गा एंड हर वेरियस फॉर्म्स डेविटीज सेलिब्रेट द बर्थ ऑफ लॉर्ड राम विद प्रेयर्स रिचुअल्स एंड ऑफरिंग्स व्हाइल आल्सो कंटिन्यूइंग देयर वर्शिप ऑफ गॉडेस दुर्गा ड्यूरिंग द कल्मिनेशन ऑफ नवरात्रि This convergence creates a unique and spiritually significant occasion as devotees simultaneously honor Lord Ram and the divine feminine energy represented by Goddess Durga.
बहुत अच्छा मंदिर सजाया गया हम लोग पंडितों ने बहुत अच्छी तरह से सजाया है बहुत सभी लोग आए यहाँ पे दर्शन करें मैं ये चाहता हूँ आज के दिन पूजा अर्चना करें और अपनी मनोकामना पूरा करें
Ram Navami holds immense cultural and religious significance in Hinduism. Though the ways of celebrating Ram Navami may have evolved, its essence as a symbol of faith, unity and love continues to resonate in the hearts of millions across India.
Moving on, Jammu and Kashmir has experienced significant development efforts by the Indian government leading to improved infrastructure and initiatives for women empowerment. The region has witnessed enhanced road connectivity and various programs aimed at providing opportunities for women to become self-reliant. For instance, the Indian Institute of Carpet Technology in Bandipura has trained tribal girls in carpet weaving, offering them employment and economic independence. This initiative marks a positive step towards addressing the socio-economic challenges in the region and empowering its residents.
The region of Jammu and Kashmir, often known for its scenic beauty and rich heritage, has long been unprivileged in terms of regional and societal development. However, with the constant intervention of the Indian government and the local administration, the valley is no longer the same. In recent years, Jammu and Kashmir has seen a significant push for development, leading to a major improvement in road connectivity and other infrastructural developments. The Indian government is also making remarkable efforts for women empowerment to make them self-reliant and independent. Numerous government schemes and programs have changed the lives of women in the region by providing them with the opportunity to earn a livelihood and to aid their families. In one instance, the Indian Institute of Carpet Technology, IICT, in Jammu and Kashmir has taken the initiative to train tribal girls in a village in Bandipura in carpet weaving with the aim to make them financially independent. This training center has given a new lease of life to carpet weaving in Bandipura, employing around 20 girls in the center, the first ever institution providing skills to the local tribal girls in the region.
हमारे यहाँ कश्मीर में कालीन के नाम से कश्मीर को जाना जाता था तो आज ये खत्म हो चुकी धीरे धीरे क्या ये बिल्कुल खत्म हो गई थी तो अभी यहाँ पे हम लोगों ने ये एक नया सेंटर स्टार्ट करा है जिसमें कालीन वगैरह बना रहे हैं तो इसमें 20 लड़कियाँ जुड़ी हुई हैं जो ट्राइबल से बिलोंग करती हैं सारी और सारे मैक्सिमम लड़कियाँ यहाँ पे पढ़ी हुई हैं ग्रेजुएट हैं कुछ 12th क्लियर करा हुआ इन्होंने तो सारे पढ़े लिखे बेरोजगार हैं तो बेरोजगारी से बेहतर है कि घर में बैठने से बेहतर है कि यहाँ पे आके कुछ काम सीखें।
The change is evident today as welfare schemes and programs have begun to impact the lives of women in the Kashmir Valley. In another instance, the Umeed scheme, also called National Rural Livelihood Mission Umeed, has brought hope to many who aspire to become self-reliant. Women under the NRLM self-help group scheme are reaping benefits through learning courses like tailoring and establishing small businesses. These women have also formed groups of 7 each and are availing government loans at minimum interest rates.
उम्मीद से हम 2 साल हो गए हम उम्मीद के साथ जुड़े हुए हैं और उम्मीद में आके हमें काफी फायदा हुआ है हमने बहुत कुछ नया सीखा है हम यहां जब भी आते हैं कोई नई चीज ही सीख के जाते हैं यहां से हमें अचार बनाना हमने आईटीआई भी की है हमें वहां भी कोर्स करवाया था इन्होंने 15 दिन की हमने आईटीआई कोर्स स्टिचिंग की है और हमने लोन जिसको लोन की जरूरत होती है उसको लोन भी मिलता है और वो भी कम से कम इंटरेस्ट में और बिना गारंटी के यहां पे लोन दिया जाता है
Women in rural and remote areas associated with the Umeed scheme have opened various businesses including grocery stores, boutiques, dairies, pickle making, spice production, tailoring shops and basket weaving and sweater making units. The program is equipping women with new skills in areas relevant to local needs and market demands. While such initiatives are not only making them self-sufficient to aid their families but also the breadwinners for them.
ये जैसा कि आपने देखा कुछ बहनें ने यहाँ से लोन लेके अचार का शुरू किया है कुछ ने चीड़ पाइन की ट्रेनिंग करी है वो कुछ हैंडलूम का कर रहे हैं इसी तरह से जिनका भी जिनका इंटरेस्ट जिस फील्ड में होता है हम लोग उन उसी फील्ड में उनको एक तो फाइनेंशियली हेल्प करवाते हैं जैसे कि हमारा ग्रुप्स का हो गया वहाँ से मिल जाता है फिर बैंक भी हमारी हेल्प करता है हमारा डिपार्टमेंट जो है वो हमारी इन महिलाओं की हेल्प करता है तो उसके बाद जो दूसरा होता है कि लाइन डिपार्टमेंट्स जो हैं हम कंसर्न डिपार्टमेंट्स के पास जाते हैं तो उनके साथ भी हमें काफ़ी अच्छा कॉपरेट मिलता है उनसे
Schemes and programs like these are helping women in Jammu and Kashmir gain financial independence, improve their social status, and contribute more effectively to their communities.
Yeah. And now some of the stories that made news recently.
As spring unfolds its vibrant palette across the picturesque landscape of Kashmir, the demand for flower saplings experiences a delightful surge, with locals and visitors alike eager to adorn their gardens with nature's colorful bounty. Nurseries and flower shops bustle with activity, stocking up on an array of saplings to meet the burgeoning demand. The blossoming of flowers not only heralds the arrival of spring, but also infuses a sense of joy and renewal throughout the valley. From quaint pansies to majestic cherry blossoms, the allure of these blooms captivates hearts, driving enthusiasts to flock to nurseries in anticipation of adding a touch of nature's splendor to their homes. Months after PM Modi's Lakshadweep visit hogged the limelight, Indian beach destinations have attracted tourists. While Lakshadweep became the talk of the town, Andaman and Nicobar Islands have also gained footfall of travelers. Renowned for its serene beaches, the destination continues to captivate travelers seeking tranquility and adventure. Tourists were impressed by the facilities at the beach, and they also called it budget-friendly compared to Maldives. The visitors enjoying their vacation in Andaman also lauded the center for the developments of the islands. Padma Shri Hemchandra Goswami, a resident of Majhuli, Assam, the world's largest river island, is renowned for his traditional artistry in mask making. Born in 1958, Goswami inherited the craft from his father and has since dedicated himself to preserving and promoting this ancient Assamese art form. Specializing in masks used in cultural, religious and traditional plays, Goswami employs organic materials and centuries-old techniques such as bamboo sticks and natural colors like cow dung and clay. His masks, worn by stage artists in performances like Ram Leela, not only showcase Assam's rich cultural heritage, but also ensure the safety of performers from skin diseases. Beyond his artistry, Goswami has tirelessly imparted his knowledge to others, providing employment opportunities and attracting both local and foreign students to learn this unique craft. He was honored with the Padma Shri Award in 2023 for his contribution to the field. Expressing his vision for the future, Goswami emphasizes the importance of expanding and preserving this art form for future generations. He views his students as family and takes pride in the recognition bestowed upon this secular art form, which transcends caste and creed.
Moving on, various religious sites across Jammu and Kashmir witnessed a surge of Kashmiri Pandits as the community joyously celebrated the Navre festival. Navre, marking the new year for Kashmiri Pandits, saw a significant gathering at Srinagar's Vaishnag temple. After a hiatus of 35 years, this revered celebration returned, symbolizing a new dawn for Kashmir. Amidst many festivities across the region, Eid and Navre were joyously commemorated, fostering brotherhood and unity. This momentous occasion sends a powerful message of harmony, not just for the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir, but for the whole world. Take a look.
In the heart of the breathtaking Kashmir Valley, amidst the tranquil beauty of Srinagar, the ancient Vaishnag Temple is reclaiming its lost splendor. On the auspicious occasion of Sapt Rishi Samvat 5100, the Vishwa Kashmiri Samaj and Vaishnag Sthapan Trust joined hands to orchestrate a celebration like no other, the Navre celebration. It was a day that not only marked the beginning of a new year for the Kashmiri Pandit community, but also reignited the flames of cultural pride and unity.
ये फंक्शन पहले भी होती थी मगर आज 35 साल के बाद पहली बार होता है जो नवरे हमारा है, जो आज से हमारा साल स्टार्ट होता है, 5100 का हो चुका स्टार्ट हमारा, तो इस दिन हम यहाँ पर सब मिलते थे कश्मीरी पंडित। इसी के इस मिलना क्या, मिलने में संस्कृत में और कश्मीरी बोलते कि इकवट, तो यही यहाँ पर होता था, इकट्ठे मिलते थे उस दिन। पहली नवरात्रा थी, फिर यहाँ पर हम कुछ बनाते थे, जो जिसका फास्ट होता था वो फास्ट के हिसाब से खाता था, जिसका नहीं होता था उस हिसाब से, और यहाँ पर हम बातचीत करते थे, अपने दुख सुख की बातें रखते थे यहाँ पर। उसके बाद नया कश्मीर का आगाज आज हुआ है इस वैचारनाग में, और यही बड़ी मैसेज है पूरे देश के लिए। मैं कहता हूँ देश के लिए क्या, पूरे वर्ल्ड के लिए मैसेज है। मैं भी बहुत खुश हुआ।
Vicharnag Temple earned its name as the hub of intellectual discourse, where Kashmiri Brahmins traditionally convened discussions to deliberate upon the Panchang, a Hindu calendar system that details the auspicious timings and events in the universe. There was an incredible energy among the Kashmiri Pandit community, who came together to honor their culture and traditions. In commemoration of Navre, the Kashmiri New Year, the community performed aarti and havan ceremonies, extending wishes for a peaceful and harmonious Kashmir for generations to follow.
जो हमारा यहाँ पे नवरा मिलन है वैचारनाग में, हम 34 इयर्स के बाद यहाँ पे आए, 34 इयर्स के बाद आज पहली बार यहाँ पे नवरा मिलन हुआ, वो भी आज ईद के दिन। ईद भी और नवरे भी, ये मिलन जो यहाँ पे इस धरती पे हमारी मातृभूमि कश्मीर की वतन पे जो है, हम बहुत ही खुशी से आज इस चीज़ को सेलिब्रेट कर रहे हैं। हमें लग रहा है कि आज हमारा वो वतन, वो प्यारा अपना कश्मीर, जहाँ पे भाईचारा था, प्यार की मिसाल थी, वो फिर आज कायम जिंदा हो गया। हमें बहुत ही अत्यंत प्रसन्नता है आज यहाँ पे, यहाँ का माहौल देख के, यहाँ का भाइयों का प्यार देख के, बहनों का प्यार देख के।
The dedicated volunteers and organizers worked tirelessly to ensure that every detail was perfect, creating an unforgettable experience for all. The support of other community members in the event further exemplified the brotherhood and camaraderie the nation has upheld for centuries.
अब इनको पूरा सपोर्ट कर रहे हैं, क्योंकि इनके भी ये मंदिर है, ये ठीक से हमने इसकी रखवाली की है, ताकि हम ये जो भाई बंदा है वो बेशक होना चाहिए, भाई बंदा रहना चाहिए, हम इनके साथ हैं और इनको वेलकम करते हैं, क्योंकि ये आए हैं, हम इनको दिल से वेलकम कर रहे हैं।
The event underscored the significance of safeguarding and advancing Kashmiri culture while fostering a strong sense of community and unity among attendees. The Navre celebration, organized by the Vishwa Kashmiri Samaj and Vicharnag Sthapan Trust, was a big success. The event brought together the Kashmiri Pandits living far and wide to honor their traditions and strengthen the roots of Kashmir.
And now, some of the stories from the recent developments and happenings from around the world in our section of World in Focus.
Japanese company Yamaha Motor has announced that it would support Carbon Neutral 2050 in the Formula E World Championship domain. In March, Yamaha partnered with Lola Cars in the UK to develop and supply powertrains for Formula E in a strategic move. The main objective is to create and provide powertrains. Its components include engine, shaft and transmission, which are essential for moving locomotive power. Yamaha's engineer explained the value of this cooperation.
ローラ社はその動力ユニットを搭載した車体パッケージの開発を進めることで、2025年からのフォーミュラー E 参戦チームへの供給を目指してまいります。
The organizers of Formula E are very grateful for their active engagement. Yamaha Motor's decision to utilize its electric motor technology for participation in Formula Racing is a significant development. The Formula E race held in Tokyo at the end of March marks a significant milestone in Japan's journey towards embracing electric clean energy. Utilizing 3D printing robots at building sites, Shimizu Corporation can make up for its labor deficit. It realizes architectural structure by identifying digital design data. Even building the wall or pile outside the frame is essential. It is typically composed of human carpenters. The Shimizu Corporation uses robots that print 3D objects to create exterior frames and finish mortar piles.
建設技能労働者がどんどんこれから減っていくという状況にありまして、生産性向上であったり省人化技術というものが非常に求められております。この 3D プリンティング技術は非常に自動化して構造物を作れるというところにメリットがあります。型枠をなく構造体を作れますので、非常に自由な形を作ることができるというところで、
In addition, Shimizu Corporation developed a special mortar for 3D printing robots. It is harder than normal concrete. Shimizu Corporation is taking a proactive approach to address the shortage of human labor by investing in research and the development of alternative methods. By guaranteeing steady growth through its company policy, Shimizu is likely to create a stable environment for innovation and adaptation.
India is renowned worldwide for its culture and civilization, but its natural beauty sets it apart from the rest of the world. From Kashmir to Kanyakumari, there are many places in the country abundant with the boundless beauty of nature. Let's explore the coastal wonders of India, from the vibrant beaches of Goa to the serene shores of Kerala and Tamil Nadu, and the cultural delights of Orissa's Puri. Join us as we dive into the allure of India's coastal gems.
Stretching far and wide, the blue sea. Clear white sand and tall coconut trees. Such a breathtaking view of the coastal areas may hardly be found elsewhere. And who would not want to sit here and enjoy the beauty of such sights of the nature? This is Lakshadweep, India's smallest union territory that comprises 36 islands. Prime Minister Narendra Modi visited Lakshadweep on January 4 and shared his experiences exploring the islands, urging people to visit. He enjoyed the natural beauty while sitting on the shores and even experienced snorkeling.
जिसने एक बार यहाँ के सुंदर बीचेस को देख लिया, वो दूसरे देश जाना भूल जाएगा।
Following PM Modi's visit, discussions about Lakshadweep have been buzzing nationally and internationally. There has been a significant increase in the number of tourists visiting here. People from around the globe are coming to enjoy the beauty of this place with their families. Along with enjoying the beauty of nature, visitors can also indulge in various water sports activities here. Moreover, if you plan to stay here for a few days, there are wooden cottages available with modern amenities for a wonderful stay.
बहुत सुंदर और स्वच्छ ये बीच है और हमें आकर यहाँ पे बहुत खुशी हुई है और हम चाहते हैं कि सभी पर्यटक यहाँ पे आवे।
This is none less than Maldives. I have seen the pictures of it, and yes, we are enjoying a lot.
After PM Modi's visit, Lakshadweep has emerged as a major tourist destination. With tourism increasing, it will not only boost economic activities but also create new employment opportunities. If you want to enjoy the beach with friends and family, Goa is the top choice for many. There are several beautiful beaches here where tourists often flock to spend their holidays. People are seen having fun, playing in the sea, dancing, singing, and enjoying boating activities here. Similarly, Shanghumugam Beach in Kerala and Edward Elites Beach in Tamil Nadu are quite popular, where most people come to enjoy the sea waves with their family members. Odisha's Puri is famous not only for the Jagannath Temple but also for its golden beach, which attracts tourists. There are excellent facilities for tourists to sit and enjoy the mesmerizing views on this beautiful beach.
So after visiting this area, I feel very good. I can see that so nice the area. I've never seen such places in my life before.
India is surrounded by the sea from three sides, so there's no shortage of coastal areas here. Just like Lakshadweep, there are many other beautiful beaches in the country where a large number of domestic and international tourists flock to enjoy. These beach destinations in India are a fantastic option for tourists. The government is continuously striving to develop such areas to further promote tourism and conserve the country's natural beauty.
That's all we have for you this week. I'm your host Pratiksha Mishra, and it's a goodbye from the entire production team.